She was just a little girl, with brown skin and scraped black knees and goody ponytail holders on her braids. She didn't know anything about infidelity or low self-esteem. She couldn't understand that her father wouldn't save money for a house and that her mother didn't want to move to Georgia. She was just a little girl. She didn't know that they were leaving her father. She thought it was a good thing. After all, her mother was smiling, and they laughed, and they even bought Kentucky Fried Chicken, something they almost never did. It wasn't until she was older that she felt that anything was wrong. She didn't feel broken or anything. She would even tell you that she was so young when they divorced that it didn't matter. But soon, she found herself trying to fill a void, which was strange because she didn't even know that there was a void. The men, with their light skin, dark skin, long legs, short legs, straight hair, curly hair, good bodies, bad bodies, began to notice her looking for them. And though she didn't stop for each one, she stopped for enough of them to know that something was wrong. And she would have said that it had nothing to do with the stories she did not hear at night, or the hugs she did not receive, or the love she did not feel. She would have said that it was normal, and that everyone was doing it, and that she had needs, and everybody had a vice, and this was hers. She would say this to you. But sometimes, even before they left her, or she left them, she would go to the bathroom and sob huge, pear-shaped tears into a washcloth, or her hands, or even toilet paper. And sometimes, she would cry those tears in the midst of the act. The act that is so precious and so wholesome and so holy and so unordained for little girls like her who don't even know that they are still little girls but actually are. The act that was not ordained for little girls like her who are just looking for a father. But abracadabra, a la kaboom, one day she found out that she didn't have to be that little brown girl with the black scraped knees and the goody ponytail holders anymore. She did not have to search for him anymore because she already had a him. And while it was not the him that they rode away from on that fateful day, it was a him that could keep her from performing the act. This him was bigger than just bedtime stories and advice and money for college. This him created not just her, but an entire universe, and she didn't have to strive anymore. But remember, she was just a little girl, so when he began to draw her close, she was afraid, because little girls are afraid of strangers. She had spoken to him on holidays, and she had sung to him at church, but she really didn't know him. She didn't trust him, and she certainly didn't call him father. But bit by bit, little by little, he drew her, and he wooed her, and he told her, "You are my own." And bit by bit, little by little, she began to draw closer, and she began to walk faster and faster until finally she began to run. She began to run after him, but it was not a chase. It was almost like a dance, and there was laughter, and there was joy, and there was peace, and she didn't have to look for him anymore because he was there. And she could forgive the first him who they left on that fateful day. And she could forgive all of the men. And she was no longer a little girl, but this new him let her call him father. He said that she could even call him daddy, and she did. And he loved her. Even with his blood, he loved her, and she loved him. And what's more, her daddy was daddy to many. And he called her to tell all the other little brown girls with black scraped knees and goody ponytail holders that he is holy. And he called her to tell all the little white girls with silky locks or corkscrew curls that he is worthy. And he called her to tell all the little red girls with jet black manes that he is mighty. And he called her to tell all the little yellow girls with perfect bangs that he is wonderful. He is holy, and he is worthy, and he is mighty, and he is wonderful. And you don't have to look for him because he is waiting for you. And you don't have to be afraid because he won't hit, and he won't hurt, and he won't belittle, and he won't leave. He is merciful and kind. His very name is Emmanuel, and he is with you. Now ask yourself, little girl, what will you do?